The Ministry for Primary Industries is focused on growing and protecting New Zealand. As part of this, we work together with Māori to help substantially grow their primary sector assets. In 2012, a special round of MPI's Sustainable Farming Fund was held for Māori agribusiness. As part of this, Aohanga Incorporation and Ag Research developed the Social Return on Investment Evaluation Tool, which enables Māori to compare the potential benefits of different land uses from an economic, environmental, social, and cultural perspective.
The Social Return on Investment Tool was really attractive to me because I had done some work with Ngā Whenua Rahui with geospatial mapping, having that visual tool to help you determine boundaries or land use or stuff like that. It felt to me that it was going to be something quite pivotal for Māori.
The tool itself is a spreadsheet, basically, that brings together information about the performance of different land-based alternatives.
What a group can do is decide what's important to them. How important are cultural things? How important are social things, like the number of jobs that are created? And then this tool says, for a given land use, here's the number of jobs you might create, or here's the amount of profit you might have, here are the environmental impacts, and then it puts it all together and summarizes it.
We've been working with Aohanga for quite a number of years, and they have already gone into the path of deciding that they want to diversify, that they want to contemplate or they want to evaluate different options. So we just came together just to say, well, probably there's a way in which we can actually put a model together for you to be able to have those discussions.
And we knew that SROI was quite a normal tool in other sectors, but we'd never come across it. So there was a lot of development.
Well, my role in developing this tool was to play a conduit role between the funder, which was MPI, the incorporation, Aohanga, research partner, and Ag Research, and some of our other research collaborators that we brought on board.
MPI have been a good partner with this project, and of course MPI is quite new to the environment really. So it was a different learning curve, I guess, for everybody. It's been really good, and the networks that we've built, I think, have been extremely valuable.
I found the experience really, really rewarding to have our funder beside us and making sure that we're developing a story alongside of what we tried to aim to do. So, and it was really, really good to connect up with different groups within MPI, including the SFF team and the Māori Primary Partnerships team.
Anybody who's actually contemplating future development on land initiatives can potentially use this tool and process. It's more relevant for Māori, I think, because of the broad range of goals that they have to take into account.
The primary sector isn't just down on the farm. You know, the primary sector has risen through the ranks, if you like. The clever people now really want to know, how do we do this better? How do we ensure that we're meeting those cultural aspirations of our people, but still really amping up, you know, the commercial?
For me personally, it was gratifying to bring something different to Aotearoa, to pioneer a framework that was used overseas, and to use a Māori incorporation to do that.
The biggest challenge that we face in the primary sector is probably ourselves, actually. There's huge opportunities if we can consider smarter ways to collaborate, to work together, to leverage off each other. And we've got some great examples of that already. And of course, you know, Mitika stands as an amazing example, but there's a lot of other smaller collaborations happening all over the motu, and I think that will grow.
MPI is committed to undertaking activities that specifically foster opportunities for Māori agribusiness. If you want to explore what options might be possible for your whenua, on your terms, don't hesitate to get in touch.